Hi, I'm Mark, and I'm a certification developer here at SAS. And I'm here to share with you some information on two of our programming credentials, the SAS Viya Programming Associate, and its sister credential, the SAS Viya Programming Specialist. I'll talk a little bit about where they're similar, where they're different, and give you a little information on, you know, how to prepare and what the next steps that you might take to pursue one of these credentials. Now, both of these credentials are designed for the experienced SAS programmer, and that person is now ready to demonstrate that they are prepared to work in the SAS Viya environment. And while much of that is still the same, there are differences that you need to worry about. So if we talk about the first credential, the SAS Viya Programming Associate, this is your essentials knowledge. This is what you really have to know to be effective in working in SAS Viya. We are going to assess your ability to use CASLibs and the CASUTIL procedure and to make sure that you can access data and manipulate your data. Then we get into your SAS code, right? Your data step code that you're used to, your SAS SQL code. And while a lot of that remains the same, there are going to be some differences. So we're going to make sure that you know those key changes that you need to make so that you can work with data that's now in memory and distributed across multiple worker nodes. Then the exam is going to wrap up with an assessment of some procedures. So some of these you're going to be familiar with, like means and summary. And these, you're just going to talk about how they work on the CAS server. And then there's other procedures that are new and it work exclusively in CAS, such as FREQTAB and MD summary. So overall, right, once you have earned this credential, you have shown that you are now prepared to go from working in a SAS 9 environment to writing code successfully in the Viya environment. All right, now let's talk about the specialist credential. This is a higher level credential. This is for folks that are interested in demonstrating not just that they know the fundamentals of moving from SAS 9 to now programming with SAS Viya on the CAS server, but also new skills for interacting directly with the CAS server. That starts with the CAS language, also known as CASL. And while some of this code is going to look familiar to a SAS programmer, there's other aspects of it that are going to be new. And I think you're going to be excited about learning them. We're talking about, let me just say, for example, the CASL variables. These are distinct from your dataset variables. They exist only in your CASL program. And they can represent numbers or a text string, or they could be an array or a dictionary of dictionaries. There's lots of neat things to see there. And so you'll be assessed on your ability to use this language, and I think you'll enjoy that piece of it. Then we're going to get into CAS actions, another new thing that you'll see that's not in traditional SAS 9. And these are a syntax and a structure for interacting directly with the CAS server. The exam is going to focus on some data manipulation techniques. So accessing data or exploring data or preparing the data, and then some CAS actions to do some simple reporting, some simple analytics. But these CAS actions are also used to do all the analytics, right? So image processing and text mining, the same structure. So once you've shown that you know how to do something simple with CAS actions, such as using table.fetch to grab a subset of your data, those same skills would be used for some of the higher level analytics. So wrapping up with all that material from the associate, so being able to, you know, use the CASUTIL procedure, manipulate your data step code, your SAS SQL code, all the way through to being able to use CASL and CAS actions, you are really showing that you are prepared to work with programming in the SAS Viya environment, leveraging the CAS server. Okay, now that I've given you a rundown on the two credentials, let's talk a little bit about exam prep and where you go from here to pursue one of these. I would highly recommend that you watch our 4 tips for exam success video. But now I'm going to give you a quick overview of the materials that we have available for you for this credential specifically. So I'm on our SAS certification website, and I'm just going to quickly navigate down to our programming portfolio and grab the Viya Programming Specialist credential. I'm going to scroll down into the exam details section. This is where we're going to have all of the sections and weights of all the different parts of the exam. And you really have to download the content guide. This is going to show you absolutely everything that you need to know to prepare for the exam. Then you have the exam details, which is just a quick explanation of how many questions, how long you have, what the passing score is. We have the pricing details. And then the 2 training courses. These 2 training courses are both available as e-learning, and they both come with lab time so that you can practice your Viya programming. Finally, the additional training tools. We have SAS Viya for learners, so students can use this to get some extra hands-on practice with their Viya programming. Sample questions, so these are great as you're beginning your preparation to get a feel for what the exam questions will look like, how they're formatted. And then finally, a practice exam. Now, this practice exam is a full-length, free practice exam, and we'd recommend that you use that towards the end of your preparation as a final check before you get ready to go into your certification exam. So you probably still have some questions. I'll try to address a couple of them to get started. We've mentioned several times that these are designed for the SAS 9 programmer. That doesn't mean that you have to hold a base 9 or advanced 9 credential. It is important that you are familiar with SAS programming, and those are great skills to have anyway, because in the SAS environment, all those skills are still relevant, right? So it's important to have that background, but there is no formal prerequisite. You don't have to take the associate Viya credential before taking the specialist. There's no prerequisites for these credentials. You also may be thinking about performance-based testing. You may be familiar with our current SAS 9 portfolio of exams where you actually have to write code during your exam. That technique is not used on these exams. These are your standard exams that'll use multiple choice and short answers. You will still see a lot of code and have to interpret code to apply those skills, but you won't have to write code on these exams. So that's a couple questions. I imagine that you may have more. Please feel free to ask those questions in the comments below, or you can hop over to our community site and ask your questions there. There's lots of eager people over there ready to answer your questions, including me. So a great place to ask questions. So that kind of wraps up all of what I want to share with you about these credentials. If you're ready to jump out there and start learning some more information, especially about CASL, a little tip for you. From this SAS users channel, there's a search box. If you type in CASL there, you're going to find some fantastic content and lots of it. Everything from a 15-minute common tasks in CASL video, all the way up to a 2-hour CAS and CASL programming tutorial, and everything in between. So there's just tons of great content, and I'd encourage you to leverage that. And if you've enjoyed the video, and if you want to stay up to date with news from SAS and great tips and tricks from SAS users from around the globe, take a moment and subscribe to this channel, and I wish you the best of luck in your exam preparation.